Now, we're back. Let's try this again. Everyone's more or less fatigued. Let's see, humans. Human, half-elf, mongrel. All right, what does it say? Come on. For most people, the Mongols are little more than an urban legend. They are believed to be the descendants of those who fought in the First Crusade, when the Crusaders had little experience in dealing with the unique hazards the world ruin presented. As the story goes, during the First Crusade, many unknowingly exposed themselves to fell energies and nightmarish radiations. In the years that followed, a shocking number of children born to the Crusaders were hideously deformed. Many of these unfortunate innocents were put to death by overzealous inquisitors, or even fellow Crusaders, but some parents fled underground to raise their children outside the light of intolerance. Whether or not this story is true, the Mongols are quite real, and inhabit the vast underground catacombs and caverns below the cities. Despite their monstrous appearances, Mongols are generally hard-working and peaceful creatures. No two Mongols look the same. Each of them usually has characteristics from at least a half dozen different creatures. This strange mixture enforces Mongols' place away from the society, for they are shunned by all who fear their twisted appearance. Mistaken as enemies by all, Mongols prefer to be left alone. A tragically short lifespan limits the creature's population growth. Mongols rarely live past 35 years. Oh.
Attuned to radiation.
Damn. Cool. Mongol. This maze really collapsed. I don't know what's happening up there. Okay. Come on, Riley. Yep. Yeah. Hey, Atrocious. Yeah, I figured I would come on early. And then, like, I'm in the Wrath of the Righteous stream around, what, 3 hours from now? Yeah, 3 hours from now. And then I'm going to go on to Pathfinder Kingmaker. Try to finish that up. Right. Let's see. Ah, a human face at last. And there I thought that I'd be gazing upon the twisted visages of these troglodytes for the rest of my life. An elderly man in expensive but not ostentatious clothes approaches you. His face is peppered with several healed cuts and bruises and twisted in an expression of extreme discomfort. Allow me to introduce myself. My name is Horgus Worm. Yes, that worm. You no doubt have heard of me if you spent any time at all in the city. I have a business proposition for you. Your name tells me nothing. Who are you? You truly are freshly arrived in the city, then. You couldn't have picked a worse time, that's for certain. Only just arrived, and the city's been razed to rubble. You should know that you are looking at one of the richest and most distinguished men in Canebras. Alright. I may not be as well known as certain swaggering loudmouths who spend their lives traipsing from one ball to the next, but the Gwarm Trading Company is one of the pillars of the city, I'll have you know. Did you see the marquees in the square? I paid for those. Tried any festival delicacies? You have Horgus Gwarm to thank for that. Alright, how did you end up here? For a moment, Horgus' eyes focus on Camellia before his gaze returns to you. Like everyone else, down I went when the accursed beetle cleaved the ground in twain beneath our feet. I'm lucky I didn't break my neck in the fall, and I'm doubly lucky that I didn't encounter any subterranean cockroaches on my blind wanderings, and instead came across hunters from this settlement. Although I must say that when I first glimpsed their physiognomies, I'm not sure how to actually say that word. Physiognomies? Whatever. Gnome? Whatever. Physiognomies? What? Yeah. My life flashed before my very eyes. But they turned out to be decent chaps. Frightening to look at, but able to keep a bargain. You don't speak very kindly of the mongrels, even though they saved your life. Ah, kind words are for people with hours to fritter away on pleasantries. Horgus Gwarm speaks his mind, and he pays for services rendered not with kind words but with hard coin. I gave the mongrels my dagger in exchange for their help. Its handle is worth more than their whole village. Jubilos. Alright. What kind of business proposition? I don't know what is happening on the surface right now, but I am determined to find out. You have no intention of seeing out the rest of your days in this village, I suspect. We must find a route back to the surface, to the city, if there's anything left of it. You seem to be a remarkably strong warrior, just what we need to get through these caves and past the bloodthirsty beasts that inhabit them. You are strong, it will be no trouble for you. But I, alas, am not as fit as I once was. I can't go crawling about through caves playing at scouts. My proposition is simple. Lead me back to the city and I shall pay you 1,000 gold coins. I suggest we help this man. It is good to have friends among the Canebras elite. Money first. 2,000 gold. Good. I praise Iomade, am a crusader, not some mercenary. Keep your money. I don't need payment to see you safely to the surface. Deal. I'm not interested in your proposition. Well, I'm not actually a crusader, so I don't need to say that. So I'm going to take advantage of my diplomacy being so high and go for that. I just need a 5 or higher. There we go. Rolled an 8. Horgus' gaze is piercing. Are you taking advantage of my dire circumstances? Very well. Make it 2,000. Money first or deal? No, deal. Splendid. In the meantime, I shall sit here in the village. Alright, we have to go. Go on, go on. Don't forget our agreement when you find the way out. Be sure to tell me. Easy enough. And before I forget, let's go to that loop. Alright, or that loop. Where's Dragon Bro? Or Dragoon Bro? Oh, Dragoon Bro's here. Just don't hear him all that much. See, the problem is there's not a whole lot here to comment on. We're in a mongrel village. Let's see. Resting. Rest. Done. Yeah, I know what rest is. Thanks, tutorial. It's time. We're heading out now. Lom won't get in our way. Windog breathes in deeply through her nose, her eyes narrowing in concentration. There's a trader in the village where you can sell your surplus. Oh, sweet. So do that. Huh. Her eyes narrowing in concentration, like she's trying to taste the air, to detect even the faintest scents. Finally, she gives an improving nod. Let's see. It's time to what? To get you out of here. I'm keeping my word. Windog looks around. It's quiet now. The village has settled down. I know the shortest route to the maze. We'll take a boat. No one will see us. Are we still going to save the missing mongrels? Manda frowns. What? Oh, them. They're probably dead already. But if we meet anyone on the way, we won't just walk on by. At the end of the day, they are of the tribe. Were you watching me sleep or something? Windog snorts and turns away. You think I like looking at uplanders? I've got better things to do. Don't think you're special. Alright, Lom won't get in our way. Where is he? On the way to his death, if he decided to go it alone. Or maybe he's in a hole somewhere, crying about how lonely he is. I don't care either way. Dog's advice and lied to the mongrels, claiming that you'd never seen the light of heaven. Yeah. Alright. We're just going to leave Horgus and Anivia here. Getting you all out at once will be difficult. We'll let the injured woman recover. Do you think I like knowing there are uplanders sitting in our village? But trying to drag an injured person through the maze would be suicide. And don't even get me started on the other one. He's not going to get off his backside unless we send a litter to carry him. Are you sure the maze is the only way to the surface? Windog hisses in irritation. Do I look like someone who doesn't know what she's talking about? Yes, I'm sure. There might be other ways, but not anywhere near here. I've never made it all the way through the maze, but every time I've smelt the change in the air. Anyone who can't has no business being in there. They're as good as dead. If you don't believe me, you can wait for another guy to show up, but no one apart from me will get you where you need to go. Let's go. It's time to get out of here. Windog nods. Right. And another thing. You should have chosen not to listen to me, but you did. That means you have... Or you could have chosen not to listen to me, but you did. Okay. That means you have real strength in you. A strong person can take the truth, even if they don't like it. And the truth was on my side. I want to say... Windog averts her eyes. Thank you. You saved the tribe from a stupid mistake. They're alive now because of you. Let's see. Now let's go to the boats. We'll get there fastest by water. Alright, said there's a merchant here. Alright. There's also a bunch of loot to grab. I'm guessing this Dyra is going to be the merchant. Mainly because the only person with a name that called Mongol. Yep. You there! A tall woman with a face deformed by an enormous swelling smiles broadly at you, showing off her double row of small sharp teeth. You, from the surface, you must be tough to make it all the way here. Never thought I'd see the day. Call me Dyra. Let's trade. Let's trade! Bulk selling. Alright, let's see. How'd they clean this up? Alright, still has the same old... Oh wait, let me not sell masterwork stuff yet. Masterwork greatsword, masterwork light crossbow, longbow, masterwork dagger. Let's see. Let's trade in some equipment around here. Not the long. Right now she's just using a longbow, D8. Light crossbow is also a D8 with a higher crit chance. Let's see. Yeah. This is better. Let's see. What's 9 hits? Yeah. Nah, no point. I'll sell that, the comma. Alright, yeah, I'll sell all this extra weapons. So, masterwork and anything non-magical. Guess I'll hold on to that for now. Bazaar. Says for brewing potions and inscribed scrolls. Alright, sure. Who are you? The people around here call me all sorts. Dyra the Hoarder, Dyra the Coin, Dyra the City Girl. Like that's a bad thing. I trawl the caves picking up all kinds of things from the surface that wash down here through your sewers. I trade all kinds of junk for food and clothes. But I only part with my best finds for coins. Got no coins? Forget what money is? Well then, I have no use for you. If you want city goods, you need to pay for them with gold like city folk. Why are you so eager to trade with me? Because all the people here are no better than animals now. Dyra yells with surprising anger before being overcome with coughing. Wiping her mouth, she continues. Our forefathers lived in the city, like you. Our people love to reminisce about armies, knights, crusades, but I couldn't care less about that. Savages with clubs can fight a war. Only civilized folk can buy and sell. They've all but forgotten what trading is. They've forgotten the value of gold. They barter hides for plant roots and go on about the feats of the Crusaders. Who cares about them? I don't need help remembering. I have coins and I have things to sell. Let's trade like proper city folk. Yeah, sure. Alright, let's see. What else do we have? Cold iron, great axe. Thick pads. Let's see. When an enemy hits for a critical hit, they must pass a fort save DC 16 or become unable to attack with a weapon for one round. Sounds good and all. Can't use it though. Here we go. Quiver of Cold Adamantium. Let's see. I'm trying to think, what can I get here? There's nothing I can really think I want to buy, so I'll just get a few potions of light wounds. Call it a day. Alright. Move out. Leave. And the facts. And the facts are simple. You had a duty to protect Canabras, and you failed to do so. While the demons were plotting their attack, you were snooping on upstanding citizens. When we do our job, you don't see a thing because, shocker, nothing bad happens. There's nothing of real value in Daira's inventory, but at least you can sell. Oh. Alright. Remember the time the demon worshippers poisoned all the wells? Or when they blew up the town hall? How about when they murdered all the priests of the Temple of Iomide in their beds? Not ringing any bells, huh? That's right, because we stopped all those things from happening. Horgus and Anivia continue to their argument, which seems to have dragged on for hours already. How did you sleep? Horgus issues a dissatisfied grunt. I've always dreamed of spending a night on a slimy sack covered by a filthy rat. I, on the other hand, slept like a log. Anything's better than sleeping on a pile of rocks. And with a covering to keep me warm in the night, no complaints here. Only my leg is getting on my last nerve. The pain just goes on and on. What's the bad blood between you two about? It's an old matter. Miss Tirabehid here had the notion of spying on me, then of rummaging through my goods. I ask you, do I look like a cultist? Cultists don't tend to look like cultists, you know. That's kind of the whole problem. And you, Mr. Gworm, built a whole secret operation of buying and smuggling into the city. What was it? Oh yeah, magical weapons. How was I supposed to know that all the rigmarole with middlemen was so you could anonymously donate supplies to the crusade? Don't you see? I have a reputation to uphold. One that I value most highly. Horgus Gworm is a hard-nosed businessman, but not a good fairy from a tale. Yes, I care about my city. Yes, I wish to see that its defenders, my defenders, were well-fed, healthy, and well-armed. But to make those donations openly was unthinkable. I might as well hang a sign outside my door welcoming every sponger, leech, and parasite in the city. I appreciate your help for the crusade. No jokes, you're an all right bloke. But carrying on secret dealings in a city that's teeming with cultists is a huge pain in the backside for us lot, whose job is to keep an eye on that sort of thing. Anivia, how's the leg? The girl scrunches up her nose. Well, it hasn't fallen off yet, so that's good. They've bandaged me up all nice and smeared some stinking stuff on the wound, so it looks like I'm gonna live. They said wait a day and I'll be right as rain, so I'm waiting. What do you think is happening in the city now? Perhaps the city is no more. If Descari himself appeared, there's no telling how bad things are. Can you hold off on writing our obituaries just yet? The city's full of fighters. And besides that, it's barely a stone's throw from... Oh my god, how do you say that? Nerosian. Oh man. Alright, the capital of the Crusader state of Mendev, Nerosian, or Cyan, is designed first and foremost as a defensive fortification to hold back the endless demonic hordes of the World Womb. Nerosian is also a holy city of Iomidae. Many of its notable residents are devout worshippers of Iomidae, including Queen Gallifrey, the ruler of Mendev. The cruciform cathedral to Iomidae is central to both Nerosian's physical structure and the defense of the city. The cathedral also draws faithful pilgrims from afar to worship at this renowned holy site. All right. I think our people will hold on long enough for reinforcements to come from the Queen. This ain't Descari's home turf. He's gonna have to retreat or else fight off the whole Mendevian army. What do you think of the Mongols? I thought they were just a story, the sort of thing drunks in the taverns would come out with. Now I discover that it's true. Well, what can I possibly think of them? The poor creatures are most unfortunate, with their faces and their minds so deformed. It's a miracle they're even alive. The part that boggles my mind is that they're the descendants of the first crusaders. All these years, they've been living beneath our feet in caves, in the dirt. If I'd known the legends about them were true, I'd have dedicated my life to getting them out of this place. To what end? The people of Canabras would have stoned them on sight, and Prelate Holron would have had them tossed on the pyre in mass. Whatever the ills of this place, it is their home. How long do you think they would have survived on the surface? Holron, Canabra's famed prelate. Holron Shapak first gained the trust and admiration of city's people by organizing inquisitions against suspected demon worshippers and witches. Holron and his forces of elite witch hunters exposed dozens of cultists and spies, and, it is said, executed many more under suspicion, but with no real proof. These events started the Third Crusade, widely accepted as the least effective and most self-destructive of the four crusades. Still, Holron evoked respect and admiration in the populace as well as fear, and agreed to guide the city as its prelate. What are you going to do when you get to the surface? I'm going to go home. Last I knew, I owned a very fine mansion. I shall see if it's still standing, or if I am now homeless. I'm going to find Erebeth. She's my wife and the leader of the Eagle Watch. As long as she lives, she won't allow Canabras to fall. All right? We have to go. Go on then, and don't dilly-dally. The sooner we get out of here, the likelier we are to find some people still alive up there. Take care of yourself. Alright. Oh wait, no. So, wow, thankfully this map highlights all the treasure, even the stuff I haven't found yet. Over here. This worm, Linda. Mutated fish. That's all the loot in this place anyway. Formations. Yeah, I already looked at that. Alright. So now we're in the supposed maze, the shield maze. I'm stuck on the character screen. I genuinely don't know what to play. I said I was gonna play a Zen Archer and I'm still harking back to it, but there isn't really a portrait for it, and that kind of bothers me. Alright. We need to crawl through this crack in the doorway, and then we're in. Trust me, I've done this plenty of times. What? Yeah, you could just be a monk, but no, the problem, he has the class he wants to play, he's just trying to find a portrait that matches without having to go to the internet and getting a custom portrait that's just right. Let's see if I can, let me save real quick and check that out. Yeah, just make a new character. New character, main story, normal difficulty. Let's see here. Human. Custom character. Next. Well, it doesn't have to be human, but like he's looking for an archer, which is easy enough to find. Let's see. Here's one. You can literally find any of these. Like, just because. Let's see. So. But if you're looking for someone who has a bow and isn't wearing, like, something that looks like they could be wearing some armor, even light armor. Let's see what else we got. Okay. clearly uses knives, magic, swords, fat. Oh, here's another one. Oh no, I guess this would be in the same boat. Wearing light armor and using a crossbow more than anything. This is a character. Too much armor. She looks like she could be a Zen archer. At the very least, she looks chill. Obviously a cleric. She could be a Zen archer. She looks like she's playing a string instrument, but that could easily just be a, like a customized, well-hidden bow. Let's see.
Oh! They could have played, bows.
Yeah, they could, but would they implement it right? Let's see. Yeah, that's kind of it. I'd say this chick here, this portrait would be one of your best bets. Let's see. If we went for Kingmaker portraits though, your options are a lot more limited.
Vampire.
Let's see. No. Maybe? She's just carrying a string. I don't know how far that could go. Crossbow, so no. Probably a druid. No. Could work. Again, the only issue is, like, almost anyone shown carrying any kind of bow looks like they're wearing light armor in the portrait. But if you just went with the face portrait, it works. Let's see. This guy could work. Nope. Spellcaster. Obvious spellcaster. Spellcaster. She could work. Hey, Atrocious, what do you think of this elf right here from the Kingmaker game? That could definitely work for a Zen archer. Or an arcane archer, if you wanted to go for that route. Playing a male character. Ah, okay.
Doom that.
Well, let's see. Back to the drawing board. I got nothing. You could pick Magor Varn or Willis, you know, the guy who was sealed away and became an undead. Damn. Options are kind of limited. You could be a Kundayo or the Stag Lord. But you're right. If you are trying to go for Wrath of the Righteous portraits for a Zen Archer, your options are very limited. But if you're just going for archers in general, there's plenty of portraits of a bow user. Oh, right, no, he said male bow user. Fuck, your options are limited.
Obviously, females rule this land. Like the most leaders of the crusade. Women. Women.
I mean, but the author who wrote those stories. Alright, let's see. There is always the male monk portrait, but it just bothers me. I can understand. He's clearly using a quarterstaff. Like, now you could pretend that it's one of those real customizable quarterstaffs that can go, that can be repurposed for, like, a spear will shoot out at the end. So now it's a spear. Then a axe head pulls out on the other end, so now it's an axe. Or it could become a two-bladed sword, or even bend to become, or it could even bend to have like a cable to double, to triple as a like a bow. But that's like, that's really stretching it. Let me see. Yeah, I'd say go for, if going for the Zen Archer, I'd say go for this guy. He looks like a ranger, but he could just as easily be, you know, just an archer or anybody else. Only thing here is, like, it looks like he has bracers of archery on his arms right there. Let's see. I actually tried the Orid portrait, and that works pretty well, but I noticed a bug with Orid Rangers. What the hell? What's the... There's a bug? What's the bug? What do Orids do? That even causes a bug.
Well, I guess
it has
to be
an aspect of the. Let's see here. Quarterstaff master. Sohei. Our masters of the horse and the hunt. The bug is that their range is based on their movement speed, which should not be the case. Yeah, you're right. I guess nobody, what, did nobody think that an Orid would ever try to, a player that would ever try to be an Orid and a monk?
It would be a monk, just not a archer, not for the archer. They're for defense.
Well, maybe they got a heritage that actually does that for them. Never mind, no. Let's see, can cast Stone Fist once per day, Lead Blades once per day, Color Spray once per day. What? Why would you? I mean, as an archer.
They would not be archers. They're usually
guards. Oh, no, here we go. The base Orid can get a +2 bonus to strength and wisdom and a -2 to charisma, so they can work as a monk.
That's not the Zen Archer.
What does Stone Fist do? Spell transforms your hands into living stone. Your unarmed strikes do not provoke attacks of opportunity and deal 1d6 bludgeoning damage. Yeah, that's not that bad. Yeah. At least that's the best bet you got. There is the Student of Stone archetype that I've also tried out that is specific to Orids.
So they do have racial archetypes in the game.
Well, no, I could probably make any race into this. Oh, no, it is a prerequisite. You have to be Orid. Yeah, you're right. Technically, this guy works for, like, if you can find a really generic-looking character that doesn't hold any weapons at all, that would work for any possible build you'd want. Like, this aura is just in a robe behind in front of a waterfall with, in cross-legged meditation. You could give him any weapon ever and it would still fit. You know, anything that shows them just, like, not in a serious situation. Or holding a weapon would actually work. Unfortunately, you can see that this guy has a weapon on him. But even then, you could just say it's ceremonial and and make this guy a spellcaster. Let's see. Same for her. She's just wearing robes. Let's see, male characters are always shown in it. Oh, this guy's got like a shit ton of weapons, so if you were making any type of heavy armor user, that'd be fine. Yeah, you're right. Alright, so you want to make a male Zen archer. Do you have the race? You have decided on a race, though? Did you want to be an Orid? Hey bro, you up for you okay with a breakfast burrito? Alright. Let's see. I don't know if Atrocious can hear me anymore, so I'll be here in about like 6 minutes. Maybe less.
Here you go. And she got you. It was one of those situations where someone at work's eyes were bigger than their stomach. Darn.
And I'm back. Let's see. Guess I'll give Student of Stone another shot. They get Elemental Fist, but their movement speed is slow, though. Like, I haven't really ever noticed this movement speed being a huge detriment to characters. Most of the time when speed matters, you probably already got... is probably around when you've gotten the haste spell. Plus, don't monks already get, like, an ability that increases their movement speed normally? Alright, well... glad you were able to decide on a build to try. And remember, like, well, again, I don't know if there is one, but I'm pretty sure if Pathfinder Kingmaker had it, they probably have the retraining thing here, so... just... dive in. Student of Stone omits the movement speed bonus of monks. Oh shit, you're in trouble. No, you're probably still fine. Again, haste spell. Using potions. Yes, I know how to use potions. I'm fine. It still sucks if you really wanted to try the, Zen Archer, though. Were you dying from a monitor lizard? Well, let's see. I had a max HP of 16. And, see, the lizard hit me for... Why much did this lizard hit me for? Yeah. 8 damage? How'd I go down from just 8 damage? Did it get 2 attacks off me or something? Oh well. I didn't die, I lost consciousness. There's a difference. No, I just finished a long rest.
What's on your mind? I wonder.
What's our HP at?
16. Well, max HP is 16. Magnesium Turinos. Alright, now I'm at 16. Use Arcane. Object Bond. Alright, let's do this. Lore Religion.
I am helpful, am I not?
Bas Relief of Baphomet, Demon Lord, Lord of the Minotaurs, and Lord of the Labyrinth. Oh, that's telling. There's also the option of taking Akon's portrait and make a Demon Slayer, but that's just a handful. Considering how many like classes and races, it's doubtful they'd be able to make a portrait for every single combination. What do we have? Baphomet Cultist. Okay.
All this waiting bores
me. Just charge him and kill him.
Future awaits us.
Charge that cultist.
You can trust me.
I trust you to charge that cultist.
I'll be able to report to you then.
Only you deserve my obedience.
Well, that's very sweet. They can actually... They can actually, they just didn't bother with it. Oh no! Neophyte sharpshooters. Which died fairly quick. And not before hitting me for 6 damage. And they're always gunning after me. Everybody wants to be a dragon slayer. Alright. Nice. Inflict moderate wounds. Alright, you know what? And they found some new armor. Well, if they can and they're just choosing not to, I would still try to give them the benefit of the doubt and say that, you know, well, you are in front. Yeah, I know. But in that last one, I'm pretty sure, Sela was the first one in front. That doesn't matter. Let's see. Light crossbow or heavy crossbow? Use a heavy crossbow. Light armor. Yeah. Use leather armor instead. There. I'm actually going to equip the Scrolls of Inflict Wounds. scroll of PS for me. I feel we need it. This time I'm going to actually, this gameplay, I'm going to try to use all the consumable items. You have the option to pick a lock or break a lock now. Just leave Windu with a bow. You can find composite bows if you search in this maze. Huh. Oh, shit. She has a strength of 16. Yeah, you're right. Yeah, alright. I'll just do that. Although there's no real difference except for a times 3 crit. Or a crit through a 19 and 20. No, whatever. Pick the lock. Oh yeah, the Mongols have broken stats due to being Mongols.
I hope you appreciate this.
Alright. See, you can attempt to open any lock chest either by picking the lock or breaking it open with brute force. No checks are required to break open a chest, but it will take some time. Some of the contents will be broken in the process and lose some of their value. Alright. Just another chest. What the hell happened here, anyway?
Head on!
Still sucks that Mongols don't live past age 35.
Pay attention!
Oh well, most adventurers don't make it past age of 35, so, eh. All right, this is what you told me about this before. Where the trap can be disarmed. Yeah.
I am helpful, am I not?
Right. Elemental essence can be used to make scrolls. Loot books. Scroll of Bear's Endurance, Scroll of Prayer. Scroll of Bless, Prayer, Tome of the Minotaur, Sermons from the Labyrinth. It's a good thing they added the option to bash chests, but it's just pointless when you have such a good lockpicker on your team. Yeah, why is she good at lockpicking? Plus 13 bonus. The competence bonus from being a courtier, plus 3 from skill focus. Oh, she has skill focus. And a dex of 19 upon entering the game. Come on. Well, that's actually just really, really goddamn good. I was kind of worried that we were going to get somebody that was like, all right, so who's the Valerie of the group where you have subpar stats and you have to really work to make them a feasibly good build? Which was fine to do, just wish it wasn't like made to purposely have to have work done. Let's see here. O mighty be our Lord, formidable and sublime. His body is a bastion of flesh, rising up above all minotaurs. His head with the visage of a goat is crowned with horns of flame. His shoulders and raiment are emblazoned with great runes, telling of his wisdom and might. In his hand, he wields Izergal, his death-bringing scarlet glaive. Its dark blade cleaves the torments and torments those who cling to false virtues and who grovel before gods. God damn. Hail Baphomet, hail Lord of the Beast of Galarian and Lord of the Labyrinth. Huh, what did he say? To be fair, Camilla is technically the Valerie of the group. Bullshit! She has amazing stats, but is lacking in her spellcasting stat. I don't think it matters. Hail the Scions of Baphomet, the mighty host uncountable in number. I speak the truth. Bow down before your lord and master and let his will lead ye. Worship at his feet and ye shall receive what ye desire. Alright. Here's the thing about having what's her spellcast? Her spellcasting stats, wisdom? Because she's got a 16 in wisdom. What's a shaman spellcasting stat? Hold on. Class. Courtier. No, that's not it. Yeah. Weapon finesse. Okay. Green faith. That's her religion. Where's the part that tells me about the class? Weapon proficiency. Light armor. Medium armor. Object, spirit weapon enchantment. I'm not seeing anything that even mentions her spellcasting stat. She has a hex that gives her a +2 natural armor. It's wisdom, and shamans can cast up to 9 spells, or up to level 9 spells, so 16 is decent, but sort of low. Wait, the green faith is an option? According to this, her deity selection is green faith. See, the green faith is a naturalistic philosophy based on the belief that natural forces are worthy of attention and respect. Followers of the green faith meditate daily, commune with natural forms of power, and show respect to nature in all things. This just sounds like a druid.
Yeah, something.
That's fine. Let's see. Windog worships Lamashtu. Sila worships Iomade, and I chose Iomade as well.
Something else is.
Oh shit, that has an effect on that? Oh man. I didn't get that far in this game yet. Sila seems nice, but she doesn't seem my type. Ooh. Yeah, she's a little sicker, man. Sila can't be romance anyway. Alright! I like Sila. Old map of Avastan. Scroll of Lesser Restoration. And 2 scrolls of Inflict Light Wounds. Right, well, we have a Baphomet cultist. You know, Camilla, how about you sit back real quick? Just for a bit. And then...
Demand your blood.
Windu, on the other hand, well, she's weird. strong but weird.
Over there.
Good luck. Extensive but slightly water-damaged collection of writings on rituals and demon worship. Window doesn't seem bad. I feel like there's going to be a moment in the game when she... Like, you know, they're probably going to have someone be the traitor. I'm pretty sure it's just going to be the evil character because it's so easy to be the evil. That one. Hey, I got a masterwork glaive. Let's see, and breastplate armor. Alright. Let's see if I... Will I be switching up? Well, yeah, I definitely will use this instead. Let's see, what's the glaive look like? Masterwork glaive. Yep. Please search the Baphomet cultists. They all carry masterwork glaives for some reason. Oh, I know why. I just finished reading it. Baphomet uses a glaive. The figure of their worship. You know, it's like why Tristian was found with a scimitar. Like, generally speaking, characters use the weapon of their deity's faith. Usually. Nothing else here. Yeah, but masterwork. That means they have funds. Well, cultists tend to run those types of scams.
Pay attention.
Or operations where they demand tribute. Got it. Why is this maze full of cultists, though?
Why not?
I guess that's a fair counter-argument. Why not? Hey, the armory. Cultist champion. Alright.
Battles await.
I like this guy.
I'll help where I can.
This voice actor's just great.
I heed the voice of the spirits.
I'll heed the voice of this. Charge!
You'll make a fine trophy.
Oh, crap. Alright, got him. Because it's a cultist den, if that wasn't obvious by all the banners, it's a Baphomet in the maze. Okay. Well, I get that it's a cultist den. I guess the question I'm trying to say is, like, why, like, the way Windog made it sound like it was a maze that was going to be full of, like, you know, constructs or bugs, you know, or skeletons, not living people. Ooh, that's creepy.
That's what's gonna happen.
Masterwork javelins, warhammer, sickle. Dwarven war axe, dueling sword. Hey, that's neat. And what the hell is this? A falcata. 19 to 20 crit times 3. Ooh, shit. Maybe I should go for that. I thought that too at first, then I found the statue depicting Baphomet further. Oh.
Onwards!
Take a wrong with the blade.
Lockpicks. Oh. Lockpicks can help you handle harder locks. They can be found among loot or bought from a vendor. The lockpick is expended upon use and gives a bonus to the trickery skill check as the character attempts to pick the lock. To be able to use the lockpick, the character must have at least one rank in trickery skill. We'll encounter more and more advanced lockpick types as you progress through the game. Sweet! The falcata has similarities to the axe. It's a good weapon, but among the rare finds. Ah, goddammit. Let's see, a spear, a long spear. So one's a reach weapon and one's not. I don't think there's any other similarities here. Masterwork Warhammers. Let's see. Yeah, it just seems like this would be the falcata is just a better longsword. And only in the fact that it's a x3 critical hit as opposed to a x2. That's it. Doesn't have a whole lot else going on.
No one stands in my way.
All right, just use the. Try it again. Just spam. I'll get it eventually. There. What do I gotta get for this to work? DC 11. I'm pretty sure I have a better bonus than. What the hell's my bonus then? Use magic device. I have a 6 bonus 6 modifier. You mean I kept getting under 5? Alright, let's see, what else? Next fight, I'll use these. Well, there's beds, so there's gotta be someone in here. Just pick the lock.
I hope you appreciate this.
Alright, there's one person in there. Use Scroll of Bless. Try it again. Okay, come on. What do I need for this to work? A 21. I need to roll a 15. Right, can I get it to work in here? No. Damn. Does anyone else have use of magic device? Nope. Just me. Wow, so they don't give you anyone else but the players, the only one who would be able to use magic device, and they gave all these magic devices? It's kind of dumb. Then why make the difficulty so damn high? Bless isn't that high level of a spell. C21, C23, DC22. Can I just use it? Yeah, I can just use it. So at least I can use these, but the DC is so ridiculously high. Got it. Neophyte sharpshooter.
Let's move already.
We're going after the archer first.
We will win this war.
For obvious reasons.
Open your heart to me.
In a minute.
I am yours to command.
Okay.
Cut them to pieces!
All right. Let's see. Let's see. Just charging in blind. All right, I'm not charging in blindly, but I am just charging in. So far, it seems to be working.
Over there.
Disarm the trap.
What do we have here? I am helpful, am I not?
And what do we have here? Oh, neat. Just a bunch of hidden loot. Quarterstaff, cold iron, masterwork longsword. Which I think I already have one. Oh no, I have a cold iron longsword. Now I have a masterwork. See, Sela has just a regular longsword, so now I can give her a cold iron. Actually, does she care what weapon she has? I have weapon focus, but maybe she doesn't. Let's see. Smite Evil. Oh no, she's got the dodge feat and shield focus. No feats at level 2 for paladins. Lay on hands and divine grace. Alright, so nope. I can give her something that's not a longsword and she'd still be fine. Alright, we got anything better? Flail. Warhammer. I think I found a masterwork Warhammer. Yeah. I'll give her that. Alright, here we go.
Move out.
Inspection. Every enemy has their own unique statistics and abilities. Sometimes knowledge of an enemy's strong and weak points can be crucial for victory. To enable the hints about the creatures you fight, press the inspect button on the interface bar or the Y key. Information you get should come in handy in making tactical decisions. I mean, I thought the inspection key was Alt-Tab, but okay. That was a mistake. Yep, you can just hear the heroism coming from the way this guy talks. It's beautiful. What do we got here? Rainbow quartz.
All this waiting bores me.
It's great. You can hear the dragon within. Scroll of Firebelly. Sure. What is it? A ritual pool filled with fresh blood. Ew. Oh, that's where all the survivors went. What we got here? Purifying solution. This magical substance is necessary to clean and safely consume any food in the corrupted wastelands of the world. Huh. Let's go over here.
The heartbeat quickens.
Corrupted Mongols. Windog looks at the mongrel's corpse, her lip curling, and then turns away. Well, are we going or what? There aren't that many mongrels. You must all know each other, right? Who was that? Windog shrugs. Some unlucky fools who thought the shield maze was a good place to go for a stroll. The maze drove them insane. If they weren't insane to begin with, that is. Windog pauses, choosing her words. But this isn't the first time I've been attacked by people I know in here. Lost friends of mine would sometimes reappear, like that. They didn't recognize anyone anymore. Trying to talk to them was a waste of time. Ending their suffering was the only option. She snorts derisively. But it seems forced. Weaklings, serves them right. You never told me this maze of yours was crawling with cultists. I didn't because there weren't any. Looks like they got here the same way you did. They fell from the surface. Perception check passed. How? Our perception should be crap. But okay, game. The maze doesn't look like the mysterious place you've made it out to be. Looks more like a cultist den to me, and a well-established one at that. The maze has always been full of traps and subterranean monsters, and now it's got cultists as well. What does it matter to you? Windog studies you with narrowed eyes. I promised to lead you to the surface, and that's what I'm doing. You do not belong here. Let's go. She turns away. Saving the game is impossible. So was I supposed to go that way? Oh, yeah. The bloodstains still mar the ground. Around them are comfortable benches and pillows, somehow clearly enjoyed watching others suffer. Or someone clearly enjoyed watching others suffer. Oof. Pick the lock. 95% chance. Success. Means only a nat 1 can get it to fail.
Am I not?
Loot. Let's go over here. I wind up finding anything else. That's a little disheartening.
Battles await.
Indeed. In the meantime, heal yourself. I just have to roll above a 5. It shouldn't be hard. Oh, my goodness.
Pay attention!
Okay. What is your perception? You keep passing 0! He's just really lucky. So where is that? Oh boy. Here it is.
I hope you appreciate this.
Every trap seems to have a small little line leading to where what triggers it. That's still a real pain in the ass. Masterwork Heavy Mace and a rapier.
Over there.
The most perceptive, lacking in perception. All right.
First blood.
No. R.S. Blunden. Hey, what's up? I'm playing Pathfinder, Wrath of the Righteous, as you can tell. And so far, I'm in a maze of sorts. So what are you up to? Like, have you had? Looks like a fun game. Oh, yeah, it definitely is. As long as you're into RPGs, you'll definitely have fun with this. Let's see here. It's in here.
Huh? What's that?
Stuff. Lots and lots of stuff. Let's see. Lock. Looking.
I am helpful, am I not?
Indeed.
I lead, you follow.
see. Corrupted Mongrel Guard. What's over here? Tenebrous system of aqueducts channeling water from the river into the city, which was seriously damaged in the earthquake. Oh, so we're in the town sewers, essentially. Sort of, kinda. What class are you playing? Oh! I am playing the Dragonborn Scion, which is a fighter archetype. It lets me have some level of draconic abilities, but it's mostly geared towards martial combat as opposed to spellcasting.
No one stands in my way.
Alright, hold on.
None shall escape!
That's good. Alright. Do you remember the toggle arcane strike? Yes, I did. So all my attacks get a plus one bonus to attack and defense. Is that a tank class? Yup. There's no way around it. It's obviously a tank class. Mainly because since I get the Dragonborn Scion gets natural armor bonuses without even trying. Dragon air. Yeah, sorry. This guy's gotta be. Alright.
Spell's not working like that.
Charging is now a spell. Should be able to kick this guy's ass, no problem though. Yep. Nice. I'd probably roll some sort of heavy armor tank myself. And speaking of, we get a ring of protection. What the hell are these? Razor sharp claws. Well, let's see. The game has a lot of options, so you won't be found. Like, the biggest issue I'd say would be. Yeah, you'll be stuck on character creation trying to figure out how you exactly want your character to be kick ass. That, and, you know, if you saw the chat earlier. There's also the part of trying to settle on which character portrait you'd be fine with representing your character. Let's see here. Down. Yeah, definitely has a problem with their portraits.
They will break against our resolve.
Hand of Hossilla. We're gonna target that one. Because casters. Casters are always a problem if you leave them alone. Hossilla's orders. Follow these simple rules or you'll die. Or you will die. Number 1. Don't bother me unless strictly necessary. Number 2. Keep the door to the shrine locked. with the key I made. I don't care which one of you holds on to it. You can tear each other to shreds over it for all I care. Number 3. Don't even think of setting foot in the ritual chamber. Ever. Number 4. Keep the door to the unfinished section of the maze locked at all times. As a reminder for you feeble-minded vermin, the entrance is sealed using the hidden lever, the torch on the wall next to the door. The door itself is in the room with the blood pool where I sometimes relax. Ew. Number 5. Do something about that damn water elemental already. Do whatever you want with it, just make sure it's gone by tomorrow. Number 6. Find a better hiding place for the paladin's sword from the surface. I'll deal with that later. Oh, alright. Number 7. Remember that your life means less than nothing to me. I have plenty of people vying to become the Hand of Hosilla. By Hosilla. And thus, she doesn't even have the key. This invaluable Hand of Hosilla. I knew Radiance was in this dungeon. I didn't find it.
Pay attention!
Apparently, did I just find it?
No. It's the fourth. It's in that room after the water elm. Water elm Doble was summoned to protect the last of the
room. Alright. Let's see what I can do. Oh wait, before I do anything.
I'm losing my temper.
It's in the module.
Well, I didn't play the module. Leave me alone. Alright, let's see. Spirit weapon enchantment. Can she use this on someone else or just herself? Yeah, just herself. But she does have enlarged person. See, what is this? Battle spirit. Shaman surrounds herself with the spirit of battle. Allies within 30 feet receive a +1 morale bonus on attack rolls and weapon damage rolls. At eighth level, no, that doesn't matter. All right. The water elemental was here because of this little shine of, I guess it's just the light reflecting. Oh well.
All this waiting bores me.
Guards, no, go after the ranger first. Always go after ranged targets first.
I'll tear your throat out.
A dart. And purifying solution.
I found something.
Dangerous enemies. The game contains optional but especially dangerous opponents or groups of enemies that only the most experienced adventurers can handle. One such opponent awaits you on the other side of this door. After I open the door. Thanks. Okay. Carefully weigh all the risks involved before entering. After I open the door. Great. That's where the water, where the elemental is. Great. That's awesome. After I open the door. Let's keep that part in mind. It's like the one context clue I don't want forgotten here. Oh, it's your fault for going into the fight after you opened the door. All right, sure. All right, well, I'm just going to save, and we're going to go in and deal with this guy.
You can trust me.
I sure can. Can't go wrong trusting her. Is this swift action? Probably. Yeah, I'm going to charge in.
No reason to pause.
Hold on.
Head on.
All right.
Battles await.
Yep. It doesn't look like I'm going to get to do the charge in first strat. Oh, maybe I will. Charge. Charge.
I heed the voice of the spirits.
Yeah, hear this voice. Charge.
You mean good.
No match for me.
Go. All the damage is reduced, of course. Use your battle spirit ability. See, they keep missing. It's A-okay. Oh. Wow, it's a good thing you missed most of the time. Okay.
No one,
it hit us once, and it dropped Carmilla with one hit, but that's okay. Died soon after, just as planned.
All this waiting for.
I really expected her to be the tank with her. Holy shit, she has an armor class of 21. Does she have an armor class of 21? Jeez. All right. Yeah. Like I said, just plan.
Battles await.
Alright. What is this? Light of the Angels. Oh man, I probably should have used this Light of the Angels. Oh well.
Am I at my limit?
Oh boy. It's Carmilla, by the way, not Carmilla. She ain't black. Okay. So I got a real stickler for pronunciations. Carmilla, not Carmilla. Got it. The R is silent, but the pirate in me just has to say that R. Man. Finally.
I'll watch your back.
Let's see. I've already found out that how heavy the potions can wind up being if I actually try to hold on to them forever, so I'm gonna start using these up right now before I wind up they weighing me down. Wait, Atrocious, you went through the elemental too, did you? And you didn't find the sword here, right? Kitchen smell. One of these. Yeah. Alright. Said the switch was somewhere over here. With the torches. No, I didn't find the sword. Here. We're in the upper floors, if I remember correctly. Alright. They said it was by the blood pool, so I'm gonna go over there. They're on their way. Right. Supposedly. That would mean it's over here. I don't quite remember where it is, but I do remember it's in that dungeon. Right.
Well, I hope you appreciate this.
All right. There's a good chance it's not in here. Creepy little ritual going on over there. So we're gonna check this room over here.
I see something over there. I am helpful, am I not?
How big is this place? I know it's supposed to be somewhere near the blood pool, so alright. Alright, let's go deal with the demon. At least I'm pretty sure there's a demon in there. It's a freaking pentagram circle and whatnot. Dredges. Look at the wall behind you. When you say the wall behind me, do you mean this wall over here?
I lead, you follow.
Hand of Hosilla.
Let's move already.
All right, let's go.
None shall escape!
All right. See, Hosilla's orders. These are the same orders. Oh, but this one has the key. Alright, what was this key for again? Let's see. I'm finished. Keep the door to the shrine locked with the key I made. Okay, yeah. The bodies of the maze builders lie where they were caught by the earth elementals enraged by the earthquake. The builders' tools lie scattered next to their bodies. Alright. You said check the door behind. Check the wall behind me. So it should be somewhere over here? No. Pretty sure you meant over here. Alright. The puzzle to Radiance must be somewhere in that room. Oh no, it's a puzzle! Oh, right. Just lizards.
You are today's sacrifice.
Alright, see, like, get, go in.
No glory without
glory! Move out the way so she can go help. If there's a puzzle, I'm hoping I can find it, let alone be able to solve it. Let's see. Princess Locksmith? No, just pick the lock. 85% chance.
I am helpful, am I not?
Indeed. A bastard sword. Cool.
Onwards!
Let's see. A large, aggressive creature was kept in this cage. Judging by the bent bars, that creature is now loose. It's hello, blue, green, yellow. Thanks. If I find it. Cambion. Oh, man. Oh, but this one's using a bow, so let's get this one out. Oh, crap. One down. Two Cambions down. Masterwork scimitars. Oh. That's weird. Alright, just show me the put. No, these are ingredients, accessories, usables. Here we go. Just chug some potions. Right as rain. Potion of mage armor. No one can use it. Potion of reduced person. Until we get a composite longbow, we can give it to her. Potion of enlarged person. Pretty much just give it to the paladin. Protection from chaos, protection from law. Alright. Party's overloaded. Well, no, not yet, but getting close. Oh. Guessing this is it. So what was the difficulty? DC 15, and Camellia's got only a plus 5 bonus, so I really lucked out here. Oh, no, this is not it. But I got some half-plate armor here. 95% means all I gotta do is not get a nat 1.
I hope you appreciate this.
Yes, I do. And some loot. What do we got? A masterwork great club. Whoop. Way to go. Heavy pick. Comma. Alright. Let's see. The half-plate armor is pretty good, though. I think. Let's see, I have a dex bonus of only plus 1. So the 8 armor class is actually an improvement. I think. 22. Armor. Yeah. Half-plate's an improvement. Start increasing the armor class of everybody else here. If I can. Nope. Can you? Camilla can wear medium armor. Hold on. Shamans can wear medium armor? Proficiency, light armor, proficiency, medium armor. Yep. Huh. Okay. Let's see. Is that better than wearing a chain shirt? Yes, it is. Although, this lets her use a max of plus 3 dex. She's got a plus 4 bonus. So 9 versus 8, so that's still good. Eight. Yep. She can wear medium armor, but her dex is so high that she doesn't need it. Plus, medium armor slows her down. Oh. In that case, I guess I'll give her studded leather? Or is the chain shirt still better? Yeah, the chain shirt's still better. Alright. Save. Alright, where's the shrine with the puzzle? Oh, maybe it's here. Miss. This guy wasn't so tough. Meteor dust.
Head on.
All right. So, this isn't it. So where the heck is it? You can see it on the walls. I can? Let me see. Maybe not these walls. This is the large creature got out.
I lead, you follow.
I just don't see it. I see a bunch of shrines to demons. Oh, here's another room I haven't been in. Is this it?
Over there.
I am helpful, am I not?
How far down do I have to go to find this sword? Yeah, body. Fairy mushrooms. Okay. Cambium.
I'm losing my temper.
Charge. Together we stand. Charge. Just you.
Do not fear. Do not whimper.
Oh. Damn, he went down quick. Blood vial. Oh, there's another one. Oh, here it is. We mentioned the colors here. Oh, look at all these torture devices. Right. Yellow. Blue. Green. You said yellow. Yellow, where is that? Yellow, blue, green, yellow. Yeah. Well, that wasn't it. Actually, huh, if I blew it forever, I don't want to save that. Yellow, red, blue, yellow. Sure, we'll try that. Red, blue, and yellow. Nope. There isn't even anything to give me any kind of clue in here, anyway. Were they hoping I would just guess all day? Alright, let's try red. Just all red. Nope. It's yellow first and last, but I don't remember the in-betweens. Oh, in that case, it's gotta be this. Yellow, 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 yellow. Nope, okay. No, green, yellow. Nope. Yellow, blue, red, yellow. Oh. Blue, red, yellow. Oh, got it. All right. I'm gonna pick this lock here. 100% chance.
I am helpful, am I not?
Yup. It's real helpful when you can't even possibly fail. Sela peers closely at the sword, which seems utterly unexceptional to you. Wait, this is... No, it can't be. Her eyes light up. I know that hilt. Radiance. The sword of the great Yanil. That's what this is. But it's meant to be in the Tower of Estrad with all the other relics. That's what I heard, at least. Well, of course this rusted piece of metal must be the very same sword. Camellia rolls her eyes. I think you merely wish that this were the illustrious sword of legend. You don't get it. I've seen this sword 100 times, in paintings and in the hands of Yaniel's statue. I've even thought of going to the Astraat Museum to see the real thing in person. How did it get here? Item received. Radiance. Okay, what's so special about it? Sela frowns. Now, nothing, I guess. But this sword was legendary in its day. People say that when Yaniel held it, the blade would glow, striking demons left and right. Soldiers would see Radiance's light from afar and take heart, rushing into the fray and winning. But I don't know what's wrong with it now, or how to restore its power. All I can sense is that they made a mockery of it. You're empathizing with an object? Extraordinary. Are all paladins so tender-hearted and sensitive? Sensitive in a way, yes. We're highly attuned to evil and everything wrought by demons. Radiance was in evil hands, and as a paladin, I can tell they did nothing good to it. Who is Yaniel? No, you've never heard of Yaniel? She's famous all over Galarian. She was a great woman. She was born in Mendev, and when the Crusade started, she couldn't just sit idly by. She dedicated her life to the crusade. People say she was audacious and spirited. She was always the first into battle, and she never sacrificed other people's lives for a tactical advantage. That's how she's been remembered, as an incredible warrior who seemed to blaze with righteous fury. Roll credits. Right, let's see. In all the images of her, she looks capable of driving all the demons back to the abyss, single-handedly. But then something happened between her and her commanders. Maybe they envied her. Maybe there was more to it than that. I don't know. Radiance should be given to Sela. I wonder. Hold on now. Let's not rush into things here. But anyway, she went into the world wound without her fellow soldiers, and she didn't just survive the mission. She even brought back crusaders she rescued in there. Can you imagine? She died as she lived, with pride. She was one of the people defending Drezin to the very end. That's where she perished. Sela frowns. Don't take this the wrong way, but I really hope that she died quickly, a hero's death. Because if she didn't, that means she was taken prisoner and had to endure unspeakable horrors. I wouldn't wish that on anyone. Drezin, what is Drezin? Founded as a city fortress during the hubris of the first Mendevian Crusade. Drezin was overtaken by the demonic hordes of the World Wound. It now stands as a demonic monument to the foolish naivety of those early crusaders. Radiance can be improved. Alright. You know a lot about Yaniel. Are you a fan of hers or something? I suppose you could say that, Sela chuckles. I've always felt an affinity with Yaniel. I know what it's like to not be what your commander wants you to be. Whenever I used to feel under pressure, I always thought of Yaniel. Maybe some people didn't like how she was, but the people she pulled out of the world wound, she was perfect. And to the people she saved on the battlefield, she was incredible. And to those who keep her memory alive, she is a hero. That's what counts. How could a priceless relic end up down here? Yaniel disappeared, but by some miracle, Radiance was recovered from the battle. No one else has ever wielded it. It is Yanyol's blade and always will be. That's why it was put in the Tower of Astraad with the other Crusade relics. But now it turns out that somebody stole it. Sila laughs. I have this weird feeling like I'm rescuing a fellow warrior from a dungeon. We can't just abandon it, even if it's no use to us. It's no use to anyone down here, but what if it could be repaired? Finding such a relic here in the darkness, this is a good sign. Iomide herself must be helping us.
Sure.
I hope you're right. Inheritor in heaven, can you hear us? We need your help now more than ever. Let's keep going. Alright, so what is Radiance? Here it is. A longsword. Masterwork, cold iron longsword. Alright. The brave paladin Yanyol performed many spectacular feats with this sword. Radiance back in the day. The people of Mendev still worship it as a relic. Alright. Say give it to her. Sure. Why not? She knows so much about it. Alright, we got Radiance. Now what's in here? Two cure wound potions and two gold. That's the real prize. Demons beware. Let's see here. Freaking torture chambers. Alright. Let's see what these dretches are all about. Take them out. Charge these two.
You can trust me.
Sure I can. Charge.
Let me draw the first blood.
Damage reduction. I found out about damage reduction already with the water elemental, but thanks for telling me. Really appreciate that. Good job. Equipment. Judging by the corpses littered around the summoning site, the cultists did manage to summon a demon in the end. Ah, crud. Alright. Let's see. There's something else going on in this room. I want to search the rest of the dungeon before I go. Because that seems like I'm just going to fight whatever demon they summoned if I go that way. So, let's go back to... I think here. No, this doesn't have anything new. Alright, where the heck would I go? I think over here? No. Wait, did I already check the rest of this place? The what? Oh. Yeah, it looks like I did check out the rest of the sewer. I already checked out the blood pool. There's nothing new over there. Looking for the unfinished dungeon? Yeah. I'm pretty sure I was about to head out before searching everything. Here we go. I tried. That was key to it. Who knows? So I might find something you can use. Okay. Good job, Windup.
Pay attention.
Some armor set. Pick the lock on this chest.
I hope you appreciate this.
Potion of enlarged person and reduced person. And some gems. And over here. A cold iron dueling sword. And a battle axe. See. A heavy flail. Battle axe. Rapier. See. Fancy scale mail armor. Crypt Raider's armor. Oh, let's see. The entrance to the unfinished section is near the blood pool. Oh. Alright, thank you. It's plus one scale mail armor. It gives a plus two bonus against undead. I can hand this to... Yeah, guess hand it to her. Alright, let's see. The entrance to the unfinished section is near the blood pool. No, that's not the blood pool. It's the blood pool. Here's the blood pool. So it's near here somewhere? Or am I thinking of a different, or is there some other spot? Just check the walls. Okay. Oh, here it is. Here's the clue that you're supposed to use to solve the puzzle. These portraits here. Yellow, red, or yellow, blue, red, and yellow. There it is. If I had been paying closer attention, I would have seen that already. But these portraits are the clue you need to figure out how to get Radiance. Who pays attention to that stuff that early? Alright. So, let's check the walls. Well, if there is anything, I haven't seen it. Oh well. Alright, that's that. Camping. There are tough battles to come. Your heroes are tired and might have run out of spells. Replenish your power, set up camp. Sure, what could possibly go wrong?
Onwards.
Let's take a well-deserved long rest. Let's see. Travel. Alright. Protective rituals, camouflage, and night watch. Okay. Protective rituals reduce the rate at which the corruption of the abyss grows during rest. Excuse me? Atrocious, what's the corruption? Yeah, bro, what's the corruption?
If you don't, you lose out of wisdom and intelligence. Your character is 20. And you become part of that, you know, what happened to the Mongol.
Oh.
That's throughout the game.
To conduct these protective rituals, a character must make a successful lore religion skill check. Oh, shit.
That includes demon lords, devils, angels, and also all out. It's outsider influence.
Okay.
It's the wild magic portion of the material.
Oof. I don't like my odds. See, the corruption is a meter that when it reaches a certain milestone will decrease your stats. And Dragoon Bro explained it. Yep. Alright. With a +3 bonus to my bonus and the DC being a 17, I think I'm just gonna... I don't really need to take a long rest, everybody. Long resting, it's overrated. I got health potions. I'm fine. Fuck that. That ain't gonna be one of them this time. Praise Iomade. And he got cut down pretty quick. Here you are, huddled together like a herd of animals. Pitiful monsters, not human or demon. Even tieflings are less effective than you. But I, your master Sava Melike, can make you better, stronger. I can satisfy your hungers. Starlings of the dark, submit to me. No, we are the descendants of crusaders, trusting a demon betrayal of their memory. Oh, these are more the Mongols. Oh! Well, who is the next descendant of crusaders who values our old legends more than their life? Beasts, monsters, and human guise, reveal your true nature. This is the sweet, wholesome flesh of a righteous Azamar. Eat, underground crusaders. Eat the flesh of the crusader from above. Find your true strength. Lulus, save you. No one except you. What the fuck? You rush at the demon. but the air seems to grow thicker with every step. You feel like you're watching from underwater as you see the mongrels fall to their knees, one after another, and crawl to the Azimar's body. You hear their fangs tearing through the flesh. You hear the sloshing of blood. You hear the former mongrels snarl like animals, fighting over the most tender and juicy bits of meat. Your companions writhe in agony. One clutches at their head, another doubles over. You feel saliva pool in your mouth. The metallic tang awakens hunger in you. The hunger turns to rage. This winged filth dares to try to bind you to its will. It dares to tempt you with the sweet scent of meat untainted by corruption. The wretch must die. Die. And still the clarity remains with you. Somewhere deep down, beneath the veil of rage and anger, you sense the light trying to break through. Angel of Mystic Path, seize the light within you. Demon Mythic Path, succumb to the rage. Ah, oh, man. Where's my dragon at? Alright, so I'm gonna hit escape so you can stop hearing that flesh getting eaten. Give me a sec. I need a moment to think.
Yeah, demon.
I might.
Just my demon.
Succumb to rage, but seize the light within you. Should I do? Yeah, that's true.
Just take some angel power and then fuck it.
Yeah, okay. He sees the light hidden within. By sheer force of will, you master your rage. And, almost in response, warmth suffuses you from within. Warmth and joy from a simple realization. You can win. You can save these people. The power of heaven bolsters and guides you. Its light breaks free and, enveloping the mongrels, grants them the gift of blissful oblivion. Lowering your gaze, you see a scarlet stain on your chest. The wound has reopened, and instead of blood pouring forth, you see only radiant light. Oh. Wow. The demon convulses in pain when the light reaches him. What are you? Destroy this vermin. Priscilla points at you. He's already wounded. Windog, kill. Windog takes a step forward. I no longer serve you, you bitch. Not you or your flying monkey. I always fight with the strongest side. Lon emerges from the shadows, knocking an arrow in his bow as he moves. What did I miss? A dramatic showdown? Oh, it's you. Perfect.
None shall escape.
Oh, this Priscilla will go down easy. I think she's just a caster.
Ha.
Yeah, nope. Yeah. Almighty Savamelech, your faithful servant invokes you. Demons, protect your mistress. Demons always make the worst guards. Just shot her. There we go.
They didn't have a choice. They were forced to do it.
Lon stares at the mongrels lying senseless on the floor.
Keep telling yourself that, Lan. There is always a choice. They could have chosen to die, but now they're going to live and become stronger. I know that from personal experience.
Shut up! You're not just a traitor, you're a monster! The young ones, they believed your stories, and you lured them to a demon and watched them eat human flesh!
Lon turns to her, his face twisted in fury. The half lizard is snarling, the eye narrowed. The words come out like a growl.
I was trying to make them strong. What have you done for them? What were you doing while I was looking for ways to bring strength to our tribe? You're useless, Lan.
I led by example. I trained. I tried to become stronger so I could go to the surface and maybe do something worthwhile with my stupidly short life. And I will do it. I might be the one to bring our whole tribe to the surface. But you? Why would you want any power that turns you into a monster? These young guys and girls, they trusted you. And they were turned into mindless animals, ready to eat corpses at a demon's command.
I went through the same ritual as them, and I didn't become an animal. I conquered my anger. The anger that has been building and building in every one of us for decades. Unlike you, I have no intention of just lying down and politely accepting death. I will rise above all this, while you'll still be stuck with your pride, chewing on rats. Who do you want at your side? The person who betrayed the demons to follow you? The person who will do everything you say and bring glory to your name? Or this trash?
I mean, that's a hell of a sales pitch.
Yo!
Like, damn.
I'm done stuff. Why you just say that?
I'm trying to go with the mindset of like a dragonic being, you know, value strength and all that, but that doesn't mean I want to be a mindless monster about it, so, you know.
Neither are they.
Yeah, I know they're not.
Well, you're not even a demon bat,
dude. You're
great.
Right. Oh, no, I just did that because I'm not a barbarian. Like, that's it just screamed barbarian. If I was a blood rager or something, I totally would have done that, regardless of alignment. Alright, let's see. Inspect the wound on your chest. The bleeding, deep wound on your chest is gone, like it was never there in the first place. The skin is totally smooth and unmarred.
It's gone. It was just there, and now it's gone. It's gotta be some kind of demonic trickery. You need to have a cleric look at that.
As if you know anything about demons and their powers. Some dark force cast its gaze on him and chose him from among all others. There's magic inside this uplander that is beyond your meager understanding. And all you have to say is go see a cleric. You're pathetic, Lan.
Lon, how did you find your way here?
Just kept going until I found it. You can find a way into anywhere if you try hard enough. And besides, I also remembered some of this traitor's stories. At least some of them were true. But that doesn't matter now. We need to tell Sol everything, and then we need to get out of here.
We? You think you're the one going to the surface with them? Isn't that sweet?
So you've been serving Savamalek this whole time, Windog?
Better to serve a strong master than to eke out an existence in a dark hole with no hope. I am of the Neethers. Our lives are short, but we are hardier than humans. I realized a long time ago that I was capable of more than this life offered, and I follow whomever is the strongest. You scared Savamalek. Hosilla has fallen. Now, I wish to serve you.
I thought you were proud of your heritage. But you're willing to crawl on your belly before anyone who's even a little stronger than you. You say you didn't become an animal? What a joke! Only animals pledge their allegiance to whoever has the sharpest teeth. Oh, but what am I saying? Even cave spiders are loyal to their mother. You're even lower than that.
Oh, so now you think you know everything about me. You're one of the best hunters in the tribe. It benefited me to ingratiate myself with you. So I acted in a way that pleased you. And the Uplander will get the Windwalk that he wants to see. I'm willing to do anything to get out of this hole. And you're willing to do anything too. Don't try to hide it. I know you, Lan.
You just did.
I've had time to study you.
I'm going to the surface only because my time has come to leave. The Uplanders are in danger. They need all the help they can get. But I'm only risking my own life. See the difference? I'll do whatever the Crusade asks of me. But I'll never be like you.
Alright. Why didn't you try to stop us from going inside the maze? You knew we might uncover your secret.
Savamalek is always in need of new servants. You'd make as good a servant as anyone else, and then... once you've gone missing in the maze, not even the redoubtable Lan would have dared look for you.
But then why did you come with me to look for the sword?
So I could kill you quietly if you found it and stop you taking it to the village, you idiot. I would have told everyone that you got caught in a cave-in. But then the Uplander showed up and I had to change my plans. I don't regret what I did. I met you. Just say the word and all the Neethers will be yours. I'll bring them to you. If you take me with you.
What exactly are you proposing to do with the mongrels?
What you saw here. They will become stronger. They will be an army unlike anything ever seen before on Galarian. Our lives may be short, but while we live, we are faster, deadlier, and harder to kill than most. I am offering you an army. An army that will win you land, power, and everything you desire.
An army of cannibals? Are you insane? You want to turn them from rational beings into rabid beasts that only want to kill. They will be slaves, and you will be their slave driver. Is that the kind of power you're so desperate to gain?
I went through the same process they did. The beast raged inside me, my mind was foggy, but I have an iron will, and I never back down. I they snatched victory from the jaws of insanity. If there are any individuals worthy of becoming my officers among those neethers, they will be able to do the same.
Don't talk to my cousin. Come on, man. I don't want to have to go through this again. Although this was an easy boss fight, still. You said you went through the same ritual. Does that mean that you ate human flesh too?
Yes. Corsilla found me in the caves. I was lost and hungry. And she offered me a choice. Die as a nobody, or live, and gain the power to change everything. Savamelek tore off a piece of an Azimar priestess's thigh. A big, juicy piece. More meat than I'd ever received in the tribe. That was the first time I knew what it was like to be happy. To have a full belly. I swore to myself that it would always be that way. Then the madness and rage took over. I came very close to turning into an animal, no better than the weaklings you saw in the maze. But I am strong. I mastered myself. I brought myself under control. I fell so that I could rise again.
You should have chosen death. Dying's better than living like that.
You're saying I should have died that day, Lan. But then who would have listened to your feeble jokes? Who would have showed you the best caves for hunting? Who would have made you a man?
I would have been fine without all that. And without you. Your death will make the world a slightly better place, Wenduog.
Oh, that's how you say your name. That was Wendog. Wenduog. Okay.
Isn't our land sweet? Look how his eyes blaze as he speaks of murder. And we were so close, too. Tell me, what do you think he'll do to you if you fail to live up to his precious ideals?
Alright. What did your service to Hosilla entail?
It was simple. I lured those I deemed worthy into the maze. To the rest, I told stories of the horrors of the maze, making them stay away. It all hung in the balance when the cave walls shuddered, and many of the young ones decided that the time of their great exodus had come. I had no doubt that Hosilla would dispatch a dozen young neethers easily. But what would become of the maze if all the tribes poured in? So when Lan ran off looking for the Angel's Sword, I went after him. Not to help him, but to make sure that the sword never reached Neethom. It's a pity that you got involved and stopped me from killing him. But then again, the evening gong has not yet been struck.
You sicken me.
Attack, you won't betray anyone again. I've heard enough.
Then you know which one of us you need. Take me with you, and I will give you an army of neethers.
Don't fall for her empty words. Wenduog despises everyone but herself. As soon as you show any weakness, she'll betray you, just like she betrayed us.
That is the reasoning of a weak person. A strong person does not fear, they act.
Yeah!
No! No! All right. This got too much charisma, man.
Yeah, there's a lot of charisma there. Like... it's like clearly the voice actors are not in balanced talent.
Damn.
Fucking hell.
Like, are you in? Or are you?
All right, huh? I have questions for you too, Wenduog.
can ask me anything you want.
Oh, no, I guess I have all.
Then you know which one of us you need. Take me with you, and I will give you an army of neethers.
You know you want to see an archer. You couldn't go through the
Let's see, why do you want to come with me, Lon?
Up there on the surface, the Crusades are still going on, right? Since I'm a mongrel, that means I've got Crusader blood in my veins. You could say it's my destiny, even. Anyway, I'm ready to do my duty. And all of you Crusaders get rations, right? With vegetables? Well, I'll be killing demons and be well fed for doing it? That's not life. That's a dream come true.
Can't argue with that. Lon rubs his forehead right in the spot where his skin scales meet, catches his breath.
I'm sorry you trusted Wenduog instead of me, and that you didn't show the light of heaven to Sol. But she can be very persuasive. She honed her skills on all of us in the tribe. I'm asking you. Believe me when I say that I won't let you down. I have nothing to lose down here apart from my chief's distrust and my friendship with the giant roaches. I'll do whatever the crusade needs. The angel deemed you worthy of his power, not just his sword, to light the path in the darkness. So I can trust you too. Seems fair to me.
Are you really that desperate to go to the surface, Lan? Why didn't you run